Where do I start? Somebody told me to start with a story this morning. So I'll tell you the story of small particle. A small energy particle around 50 years back came into existence in a 3 kg body. And the particle was born out of consummation of two people who had contrasting ideologies. And those people were my parents. And their thoughts were very different than each other. But then they had one common mission, that they wanted to have a child who is successful. So they debated for a week, and they called that energy particle as Prakash. Like she was saying, Prakash means light. And within a week, they decided that light is of no use unless it has intelligence. So they said, okay, let's name him Vimarsh Prakash. And then my grandfather said, no, that's not good. Put a surname to him. And they put a surname, Vimarsh Prakash Raina, and it becomes too big. And then when I went to school, I was feeling very shy. Everybody had a short name, and I had a very long name. And then when I was in 10th, so I cut off one of the parts of the name. And then I have evolved over the last 50 years, that small particle of energy, which is in me and which is in you, has evolved into this being, which is Dr. Vimarsh Raina. So being a medical professional and a pathologist, lot of times I see into the microscope. There's somebody who has fever, there's somebody who has dengue. What do I see in the microscope? Do I see fever? No. Do I see the pain? No. Do I see the discomfort? No. I see a very minuscule malaria. And what does that malaria do? It's impacting a whole human being. And it's impacting a whole family. And then if it happens in too many people, then it is impacting a whole community. And if it is SARS, then it's impacting the whole world. Then the people stop traveling. And that makes me wonder, am I at the right place? Under the microscope, what am I seeing? A large impact. Can I cause a change in that impact? Then I again think, what is this small energy particle which was born 50 years back, which was labeled by somebody, they put a barcode on it and say, okay, your name is Vimarsh Raina. Now, then I understand it's actually a huge computer with a RAM, and this has some gigabytes of space, and it's loaded with too much of software. There's some youngsters who are fond of loading malware, and they put a gaming software there. And then there's some people who load you with thought processes, they are teachers, and they give you some ideas. And there are some teachers who are not actually your teachers, but they are in the society. They are the vendor who sells you stuff. I had a neighbor when I was in 6th standard, Rawatji, he had a shop, and there were 1 rupee coins and 1 rupee notes. And whenever we had a torn coin or a note, we used to put it in a drawer. And we thought we were very smart. So we would collect them, go to Rawatji and give it to him. And we would buy our bread, eggs, everything. And he would smile at us. And we thought we are smart. So one day when I was in the 10th standard, I told him, Rawatji, you know, we collect all this stuff and we give it to you and you just take it. Don't you think these are torn notes? And he said a beautiful thing. He said, these are not notes. This is Lakshmi. Please understand the concept of it. There's nothing in the paper. Similarly, we human beings conceptually are particles of energy and we are formed into human beings. And this software is already loaded. There's a lot of programming already loaded in our brain. And in that programming, there is something loaded already that we have to be happy. Now, in this audience, how many of you would want to be successful? Can you raise your hands? You don't want to be successful, ma'am? What about you? You don't want to be successful. So there are four guys who don't want to be successful. I'm happy. Now, how many of you would want to be unhappy? You want to be unhappy? Nobody wants to be unhappy. There's some people who are okay not being successful, but all of us want to be happy. And our target, if you go to the church, if you go to a temple, if you go to a school, if you go to a college, is not getting successful. And the most successful person, somebody named him, there was a picture about him, poor fellow died of cancer, and he was a very unhappy person. I didn't want to name him. So the success most probably should be, you should have roti, you should have kapda, makan, money, fame, recognition, love. What did I miss? Affection. And for youngsters, most probably success means having an internet, having access to gaming. They're not much bothered about food, they can order a pizza or something like that. But why do we do all this? To get successful or to get happy? This computer tells me that we do all this to get happy. And if this program, if this gigabyte of space is already programmed, then the program for happiness is already loaded. And that program is compassion. This particle of energy, I got my IQ measured. It was less than 70. I drive one of the largest cars in this country. I live in one of the biggest houses. I have tons of friends. And probably I think of myself as the richest person in the world. With very low IQ, I wanted to share with you the only thing what I have done in life, and I have done it by chance, by coincidence, by accident, not by thought, was I somehow came to learn that this program of success is linked with the program of happiness in this computer. It's already loaded. And this program is known as compassion. When you move anywhere, probably this is somebody else's talk, I think. This is not mine. Anyway, so that's fine for me. So this program of compassion or caring for another human being, caring for another individual, is already loaded in each and every human being. Just think about yourself. Think about the difference between a tree, a dog, cat, any animal, and a human being. When you walk, you look at something, you feel bad. I saw food being wasted, I thought bad. Oh, why did he waste this food? There's a lot of compassion, a feeling for others. But then, when we go to school, when we go to college, when we interact with teachers, all of us have told us, forget about this computer. You have to do well in life. You have to be successful and then only you'll be happy. The program is already with all of you. The program is compassion. So, when I realized this program, I'll tell you some stories about this compassion. I was in my job around 4 or 5 years back. There was this boy around 16 here in Gurgaon. He wanted to go to US for his studies and suddenly he discovered he had blood cancer. He had a brother. They tried to match him and I was in a hospital. I was a molecular pathologist. I did his mapping. And when I saw his mapping, it was only half match with his brother. I told his dad that, you know, these two guys don't map with each other genetically. So you can't lift the seeds of one and put it in the other person. So he said, what can we do about it? I said, I do not know. Google, Yahoo, these are the answers. So they try to Google, they try to Yahoo. They just found that there could be people in the world who are not born in this family, yet they are genetically, immunologically identical to them, completely identical. So that means there are people in this world who would match me completely, already wired in this world, already designed in this world. They have the same major histocompatibility antigen. Your biology teacher must be here. So it's on chromosome 6. There's a segment which determines self from non-self, me from you. And that message is given on chromosome 6. And this tells me, this is not me. And then lots of us, I could have around 100 duplicates in the world. And they're actually my, not siblings, but they're my genetic brothers. And this lady around 2 years, I didn't tell you about that boy. So when finally that boy could not find a match, we tried to find out where do we get the match from. And we discovered that there is a database in the world. And this collects people who have their genome mappings done. And all the countries in the world, like a Vasudeva Kutumbakam, have assembled their genetic data on that world map. And there are around 30 million of these guys. 15 million of them are in US, 5 million are in Europe. India has another 50 to 60,000 of these. So a lot of us find, when we are sick, when we have thalassemia, when we have leukemia, find our matches there. Unfortunately, we couldn't find a match for that young boy. Unfortunately, that boy died because we didn't have a match for him. And telling you another story, the maternal uncle of this boy also volunteered. And 2 years back, he matched with a girl from Indore, and she was transplanted and she's doing well. 2 months back, there was a German lady. She was having blood cancer, and they searched in the global database, and they found that this one donor in the world, which is completely matching her. There are 8 brothers and sisters in Germany. None of them is matching anybody except this lady who lives near Gurdwara Alamgir in Ludhiana. She had registered as a donor and we had an HLA type on the international database. So me and some of my friends went there. She was very happy and excited to be donating. But did she donate? No. Why? Because her husband said, this is no safe. You should not do this. And then we kept on pestering her. And we kept on talking to the sarpanch of that village. And we kept on talking to other people. And we built a huge momentum around that lady just to encourage her. She already had compassion. That's why she had committed. She already was using her program. The people around her were not letting her use that program. And then that made her change her decision. She donated her stem cells around 2 months back. And if you really have a photogenic camera where you can measure the aura, if I get you the image of that lady after the donation, you will see the God, the energy in her. So when there is collective passion, if it is, if you add some action onto it, there'll be lot of good in the society. And when there'll be good in the society, it'll impact you also. You're in this school. If you have a collective idea, compassion for the people living across the road, you will care for them, you will mend your roads, you will not be bitten by mosquitoes. So unless you work for translating the compassion in you into a collective passion, you would not be able to discover happiness. In this transit of my 50 years of my life, with an IQ of 70, driving a Land Cruiser Prado, living in a posh house, I'm trading you a secret which I've never ever shared with anybody. Just make sure that you are able to use this software of compassion, try to help the other person around, and you will see that it will develop into a habit. There was a boy who came to me for job 6 years back from interior of Bihar. He was wearing rags, he had bad shoes, his clothes were smelling. I was in a posh hospital. And he said that I want a job. By chance, he didn't know English also. And he didn't speak good Hindi also. But his eyes told me that he was in pain. And I left my job. And I started thinking, what can I do for this boy? And I took a leave for a day. Then I sat with him. And I realized he has tons of great ideas. Then I said, look here, we have another boy who has leukemia and we are not able to find a match for him. Do you think you can set up a registry? Which All India Institute has failed. They have blown 250 crore rupees to build up a registry. They don't have a single donor. And this boy, 4 years, 5 years back, has created this registry. This is the registry that boy has created. And how did he create this registry? He's worked 16 hours a day for the last 5 years. And I'm standing here before you and taking credit of this registry, which has been built by somebody. And why did he build it? And this has benefited around 15 people globally. It has brought India's donor map on the global donor map. And we have a donor in Germany. This is the first time an Indian donor has donated for a German patient. All this happened because that young boy from Bihar, I could quickly translate my compassion into action. We offered him a job. He created a database. That database helped other people. Incidentally, it has also employed people. It has helped other people. And there is no great plan. There is no software involved. There is no hardware involved. There is no resources involved. There is no capital involved. Nothing is involved except the software which is ingrained already in your head, in your brains, and that software is compassion. My sincere, hand-folded request to you, youngsters, is please use that software just like gaming software. You will enjoy that software. Use that software to take actions. You will enjoy the actions. You will feel bloated. You will feel at top of the world. You will feel so proud of yourself because you would have moved a lot of mountains. You may have a poor grammar like me. You may not be a very strong speaker, but you will rate yourself as the happiest, as the most comfortable, as the most rich person in the world. So I neither want to be a great person, nor my family will feel great if I have tons of wealth and have cancer. But definitely my children, my wife, the teachers out here will feel happy if I am able to do something for them. And that in return will cause tremendous happiness to me. There were small stories. They were already shared with us when we were in small government schools. This was one of the stories they told us. Probably the internet is there and a lot of good stuff is there. And these stories need to be told to you now again. That there was this boy, he went into a jungle, he met a lion, he dug out a, what do they call this, thorn from his foot. And finally, many years later, this boy was caught by a king. The king wanted to kill this boy, so he put him in a lion cage and the lion smelled him as the same boy. This is just a way of telling you that if you have compassion, you would be able somewhere or the other down the line feel happy and enjoy it. That's all I have to say with you. Thank you very much for hosting me. Namaste. Thank you. And God bless you with tons of happiness, with tons of compassion. Thank you very much.